嗱 ，Mission Impossible 咧，大家可能就會聽過啦。但大家知唔知道咧？喺東區有一個嘅機構咧，叫做 Mission Possible 啦。Mission Possible 其實咧係我哋加拿大嘅其中一個嘅救援嘅機構，而我哋都係我哋教會多咗一步咧支持嘅機構之一。今日我就請嚟咧其中一個嘅同工 Nicholas 同你分享一下，咁佢哋嘅任務有幾咁特別，點樣去幫助咧温哥華東區嘅人。
Good morning, Colonia. We are so glad that you have Nicholas Talis-Espanen with us today. Nick is the coordinator, community engagement coordinator of Mission Possible at Downtown Eastside, Vancouver. Hello, Nick. How are you?
Good, Pastor Gabriel. Thank you for having me today.
Yeah. Can you first briefly share what's the mission of Mission Possible in Downtown Eastside?
Yeah, for sure. So Mission Possible was established in 1992 as a community drop-in center for folks in the Downtown Eastside, offering basic services for people struggling in this neighborhood. Currently, what Mission Possible does is actually offer part-time employment and transitional opportunities for people to move away from poverty and into dignified employment. And so our focus has many different areas, which is transitional employment, training, as well as one-on-one support through coaching to get people to a place of stability in employment and other endeavors that they want to take. And so that's the primary mission of Mission Possible. But then subsequently with that, we have a Power Breakfast and Coffee House, which is a community effort to try to bridge some of the food security gaps in the neighborhood. So once a week, every Saturday, we offer meals in the Downtown Eastside, one breakfast, and then some snacks and social activities for people in the afternoon.
Great, great. Yeah, actually, we have some people from our church also joined the breakfast preparation before.
Yes, I can imagine, yes.
A little bit about that. Okay, so Nick, for the past few weeks, how has COVID-19 been affecting the ministry of Mission Possible?
Ooh, well, what a question. So much has changed, but I think in the employment readiness program aspect of things, the one thing that's changed a lot is we have had to, unfortunately, suspend temporarily our intake of new people, right? So the need is greater than ever for people to have employment and to move towards employment in many different areas. But because of the social distancing and the way that our program is structured, we have been unable to continue with that. So our focus has been inward. And what that really means is trying to focus on the people who are in our program currently and who are going through all the steps and the training and working to make sure that they're feeling supported, that there's flexibility for their schedule, so that they are able to work towards further employment, but also take care of themselves under the current situation. So a lot of our efforts have actually been to move inward and look at the people that we have in our program. So that's been one for the employment readiness program. We've also been trying to shift a little bit to more of an online platform with some of our intake. We have offered other partner organizations to do information sessions over Zoom, much like this interview. And we've had some uptake on that, and it's been useful just kind of to continue maintaining engagement with our larger community, even though we can't be there physically, right? And so hopefully at the end of this, we can come back stronger and the connections that we have still remain intact. On the flip side, we've also had new ventures with the masks, as you can probably tell. Your generous donation of 1,000 masks have been, incredible, really. A lot of support from community groups, churches, volunteers outside of the metro area and in the metro area, just offering support. Mission Possible right now is partnering with Union Gospel Mission for masks making, as well as distribution and collection for not just frontline workers, but also community members in the Downtown Eastside. As you know, they are some of the most vulnerable individuals, many of them immunocompromised. And then lastly, on our Power Breakfast and Coffee House, we've had to unfortunately suspend the Coffee House because we just don't have the ability to host people indoors. But the Power Breakfast is such an important piece of our community building efforts and our community engagement efforts. And also it provides a really tangible meal for people, something that they can hold on to, that they can use to fuel themselves and continue with their day. So we've partnered with different volunteers and church groups And we've been able to continue moving that particular ministry forward. And in doing so, now we're looking at around feeding 300 people every week. Well, before we were feeding only 100. So there's been some changes there.
I see. So that is quite a lot of changes for the past week, I'm sure. New learning and new changes. So can you share some immediate challenges or need at Mission Possible for us?
Yeah, certainly. I think the immediate need really comes from staying connected with our community and obviously our partners and donors and volunteers, just to make sure that we can continue to do the work that we're doing to support the people in the downtown east side and to support our larger network. I don't know if you were aware, but yesterday was Giving Tuesday now, and that was a really important part of our fundraising abilities. We're still employing people. We don't want to, lay people off. We are very much wanting to make sure that those in the downtown east side who are working with us are able to continue to be employed. So, donations are really important, and people have been doing it online, they've been doing it in person, by check. And so that's been a really great way and avenue for people to meet those financial needs that as a small not-for-profit we need and we rely on from our community. And then the challenges really, I think, is mostly on trying to reconfigure what our programming looks like and trying to figure out what's next and how we can move forward in what seems to be the new regular, right? I mean, we don't really know when this is going to end. And so switching from a mind frame of this is temporary to we need to adjust our programming a little bit, maybe long term, to continue working and supporting those individuals in our community.
I see. Wow, there is so much need. And I'm sure it's not just one organization, right? And I'm also glad that different organizations are partnering together to serve the community. So Nick, is there anything else you want us to pray for Mission Possible, the staff, and all organization as well?
For sure, yes. I think the prayers of your congregation will be really welcomed, particularly praying for resilience for our staff, for our community, as we're embarking in this really unknown journey, right? We don't really know how long this is going to last, and we are continuing to do the work that we do, and resilience is, I think, a really important aspect of how we want to carry forward. And also just for the overall well-being of our community here in the downtown east side and our staff and partners and volunteers, as they are continuing to support the work that we do, they're continuing to receive the support that we give, resilience and well-being. I think those would be the main things.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. We'll use this video to share with our congregation, and then we'll pray for you and also Mission Possible.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. So thank you, Nick, again, for the time sharing the need in downtown east side. So Nick is the community engagement coordinator of Mission Possible in downtown east side Vancouver. Thank you, Nick.
Thank you so much. It's been a pleasure.